effective prevention of red eyes. People with pink eye can spread the disease to others even without clear symptoms. Wearing glasses does not eliminate the risk of disease. So how to prevent red eyes effectively? Woe to painful eyes at the red house to spread. Red eyes, also known as conjunctivitis, are common, occurring at any age, and usually increase with seasonal changes. The initial symptoms of the disease are burning eyes, pain, feeling of the eyes, blurred vision, swollen eyelids, watery eyes. Red eye diseases are transmitted through the respiratory tract, personal belongings such as face towels, wash basin. Causes of this phenomenon can be caused by bacteria, viruses. In cases of viral eye pain, it can be spread through many pathways but is especially dangerous and the fastest is through the respiratory system. Patients with red eyes may have pharyngitis or sometimes lymph nodes in their hands. People with pink eye can spread the disease to others even if no symptoms appear. The transmission of the disease occurs during the incubation period. Once the patient has recovered, it can still spread to others within a week. Wearing glasses does not eliminate the risk of transmission but only minimizes the possibility of transmission. If wearing glasses but still use face towels, wash bowls, the ability to spread the disease is very large. Red eye pain is transmitted through tiny particles when a person coughs or sneezes, through personal items, handkerchiefs, through contaminated water, swimming pool water. Therefore, the disease is contagious in children in the same school or in the same household. Symptom: eyes are painful, thick, feeling like sand in the eyes, tears and mini rust, sometimes light sleep up and make eyelash sticky. Eyelid is slightly swollen, slightly painful, conjunctivitis swollen, red. The disease usually begins with one eye, after a few days to the second eye. Accompany with cough, mild fever, lymphadenopathy, or in children. Prevention. Pink eye is easy to infect, both for home and community, so it is important to keep good hygiene to prevent spreading disease to yourself and others. Do not rub your eyes with your hands. Wash your face at least 3 times a day with clean water, clean towels, separate. Wash the towel with soap, towel in the sun. Wash your hands thoroughly with warm water, especially before and after eye drops. Daily eye wash with physiological saline, morning, noon, evening. When eye irritation occurs, patients should be rested, treated separately, using prescription drugs by ophthalmologists. If the disease does not improve after 5-7 days to see again, can use artificial saline 0.9% or artificial tears to wash away the germs, wash away secretions and rust the eyes, soothe irritated eye irritation. Wash your eye rinses several times a day with a paper towel or moist cotton, then throw it away. Need to increase nutritional supplements, fruits, vitamins and minerals increase resistance to more rapid healing. Persons who have not had the disease should minimize the contact with the patient, when contact should have a mask. In the home with sick people need to limit bed sharing with the patient during a period of red eyes and after recovering at least 1 week. Wash the bed sheets, pillowcases, towels and bleach and warm water. Avoid sharing items such as face towels, wash basins. Wash hands after eye medication. Do not look into the eye drops of infected eyes. If your child is sick, stay at home, do not go to kindergarten, school or crowded places during illness. Although red eyes are an acute illness, the symptoms are loud and contagious, but they are usually less benign, but the disease often affects the life, study and labor. There are many cases of prolonged and with adverse complications affect the eyesight, so people always have good sense of prevention and should be timely intervention when infected.